Myself, Professor Dharam Unalkat here with the subject Effective Technical Communication. Module number 5, that is Etiquettes. What is etiquette? Etiquette is a simple word which is defined as the good behavior and which distinguish human beings from the animals. We all know that human being is a social animal and it is important for him to behave in an appropriate way. Etiquette refers to behaving in a socially responsible way in the society. It is essential for an individual to behave in a responsible manner which is acceptable to the society. People around us must not feel embarrassed by our behavior and our nature. One should not behave irrationally or illogically in the public. So, this is the definition of the etiquette, which is simply a good behavior and would distinguish the human beings from the animals. Now, what is the need of the etiquette? Why we need etiquette in the real as well as in the corporate world? So, etiquette makes you a cultural individual who leaves his mark wherever he goes. Etiquette teaches the way to talk, to walk, and most importantly, how you have to behave in the society. Etiquette is essential for an everlasting first impression. The way to interact with your superiors, your parents, your fellow workers, your friends speaks a lot about your personality and your upbringing nature in the corporate or the real world. Etiquette enables the way to earn the respect and appreciation in the society. So, this is all about the definition of the etiquettes and why we need etiquette in the real life. Now, have a look on the types of the etiquette. Yes. The first is the social etiquette. The word itself says the social, you have to deal with the society. So, social etiquette is important for the individual as it teaches him how to behave in the society. Second comes the corporate etiquette. Corporate etiquette refers to how an individual should behave while he or she is in the workplace. Each one needs to maintain the decorum of the organization. Where he or she is working, you have to maintain the decorum of that organization where you are working. Next comes the wedding etiquette. Wedding is a special event in everyone's life. Individual should ensure that you have to be sensible at the wedding place. Never be too late at the wedding. And if you are in the foreign culture, never drink unconditionally. Next comes the meeting etiquette. Meeting etiquette refers to the style one need to adopt when he is attending any meeting, seminars, presentations and so on. Listen to what other person has to say. It is very important you have to be a good listener in the meeting. Never enter the meeting room without a notepad and pen. Make sure you are noted if you are not entering the meeting place without a notepad and a pen. It is important to jot down every important point for the future reference. Next comes the telephonic etiquette, which is very important in the corporate world. So, it is essential to learn how one should interact with the other person in the phone. Telephonic etiquette refers to the way an individual should speak on the phone. Never put the other person on a long hold. Make sure you greet the other person as soon as you receive or make a call to the person. Take care of your pitch as well as your tone. Next comes the eating etiquette. Individual must follow a certain decorum while eating in the public. Don't make noise while eating. One should not leave the table unless and until everyone has finished eating in his or her table. Next comes the business etiquette. Business etiquette includes the way to conduct a certain business etiquettes. Don't ever cheat the customers. It is simply unethical. So, these are the 7 types of the etiquette, which are social etiquette, corporate etiquette, wedding etiquette, meeting etiquette, telephonic etiquette, eating etiquette and business etiquette. Next topic is telephonic etiquette. An individual needs to follow a set of rules and regulations while interacting with the other person over the phone. These are often called telephonic etiquette. It is important to follow a basic telephonic etiquettes as our voice plays a very important role in creating an impression of our personality, education, family background as well as the nature of the job we are engaged with. Thus, The telephonic etiquette is a set of rules and regulation while we interact with the other person over the phone. Let's have a look on various telephonic etiquettes. Always remember your voice has to be very pleasant. Never call any person at odd hours. If your call is an official call, don't use the word like "any guess, who am I?" as the person on the other side might be occupied something other work and can be disturbed. Never put the second party on a very long hold. Always speak each and every word clearly. Make sure your voice and tone must be very clear, as the person on the other hand can't see your expression. So remember, your tone should be apt to express your feeling in the correct form. Next, if there is any disturbance in the network, don't just keep speaking. Try to call after some time with a better line. So these are the various telephonic etiquettes. Now let's have a look on etiquettes for caller when other person picks up the call. Make sure you are calling the person but some other person picks up the call. This is the etiquette for that. When you make a call, start with a greeting like good morning, good afternoon, good evening, etc. Then followed by your names and your organization name. For example, good morning, this is Dharam Unadkat here from LJ Institute of Engineering. Next, if you have called the office number and someone else picks up the call, make sure someone else picks up the call, then ask politely to put you to the person you wish to talk. Next, if you are asked for the reason of your call, give the proper detail to that person so that he can inform to the person whom you want to talk. If the person asked you to hold for a while and transferring the call, say thank you to the person before your line is transferred. If the concerned person is not available, make sure if your concerned person is not available, then give the clear message to be passed on to the person and ask for the convenient time when the concerned person is available so that you can call back very soon. Do not get irritated if you are put on the hold for the while and because the person is not available. Maintain a friendly tone and end the call by a polite thank you or have a nice day. Now, let's have a look on the etiquettes for the caller when the person to whom you want to talk picks up the call. Make sure now we are discussing the etiquettes for the person you want to talk picks up the call. First, start with a greeting, good morning or good afternoon and good evening, followed by your names and your organization name. Before starting the conversation, first tell the purpose of your calling and how much time you will take. Then ask, is it good time to talk to you? Maybe the person is in the middle of the meeting or doing other work where he or she cannot concentrate on the conversation. Keep all the information handy. Make sure you have your ideas which you have to share is handy before dialing the number. It is rude to call a person and then keep that person waiting because you haven't done your homework. Before hanging, say thank you with the pleasant tone. And last, make sure that there is no noise around you before you make a call. So these are the etiquettes for the caller when the person to whom you want to talk picks up the call or does not pick up the call. Let's have a look on some etiquettes for the receiver. Receives the call promptly rather than making the caller wait for the longer time. Greet with your full name and organization name. In some organization, people pick up the phone and greet followed by directly the organization name without saying their own name. It depends on the standards ways of communication in your particular organization where you are working. Ask the name of the person and offer help. For example, may I know your name, sir? How can I help you? If the person wants to talk to someone else, then pass the line without making the caller for the longer time. And if the person is not available, ask if you can take the message to pass on that person. Always keep a notepad and pen handy so that you can note down the correct information on the spot. Take down the message fully and correctly. pass the message without fail to the concerned person. So these are some etiquettes for the receiver. Let's have a look on do and don'ts of the telephonic conversation. As soon as you receive the call, be polite and tactful in your appropriate words. Remember that your tone says it all in the telephonic conversation. Greet and give your and organization name. Listen attentively to the caller and give your verbal acknowledgement as mentioned earlier. Always keep, as we have discussed, always keep a notepad and a pen handy to note down what you have listened. If you have to pass the message to the other person, this will helpful point. Hold the mouthpiece properly. Make sure do not hold it too far and too close so that your tone and voice will be clear. So this is the first video of the module number 5, that is etiquettes, in which we have discussed what is etiquettes, its definition, the need of the etiquettes and the telephonic etiquettes. Let's again understand some basics of the etiquettes. What you have to show to have a good etiquettes. First, say thank you. When someone gives you a compliment or does something nice, the best response is simple thank you. Say thank you. Please also remember, please excuse me and you are welcome, which are other makes a good manner. So with these words, you may simply increase your level of etiquette. Second, give a genuine compliments. A fundamental rule of good manners is to give. When meet someone, you can always think a genuine compliment to give, along with your attention and interest. A hello or how are you is the most often not used. Be generous with the sincere words of praise, warm greeting, sympathy, or whatever it appropriate to be the occasion. So use this word. One more is be yourself. To increase your level of etiquettes, never be the masked person. You be yourself, present yourself proper with the others. Let this one sink in, ladies. Who you are is perfectly acceptable and you are worthy of being treated consciously. Working out the rough edge can be lifelong process and now is a really good time to start. So again, discuss what is etiquette. It is a simple word which distinguishes human beings from the animals. So this is all about the first video of module number 5, that is etiquettes. Thank you.